essentially, when I worked at Def Jam, I was a messenger for the first 3-4 months. And I became so valuable to that company immediately that they were like, yo, you can't be on, you know, carrying boxes. We need you in the office every day. And so what I was doing college radio promotion, mixtape, DJ promotion, mix show, like, you know, Red Alert, Kick It Free, to, you know, Special K and Teddy Ted, you know, community, commercial, mixtape, club DJs, Jules, you know, I was hitting everybody off of records. So since I had my ear to the street so hard, Russell and the rest of the people there, they started asking me, like, yo, what should we put out for the next single? You know, yo, listen to this demo. So all of a sudden, I became an A&R because of my ear. Russell had given me a demo by a group called Simply Too Positive, STP, which was comprised of Prince Pooafloh, who later became known as Prince Poetry, and another MC named Pharoah Monch. I'm sure you know who they are.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
They became Organized Confusion. I listened to that demo and I bugged the fuck out. I still have it. It's incredible. I mean, there's a ton of songs on there that never came out. So I went back to Russell and I was like, yo, these dudes are incredible. Like, this is my new favorite rap group, you know? Honestly. Mm-hmm. And he was like, oh, they're too technical. You know, I can't, you know, I don't see them selling records. You know, I don't see no radio singles. You know, like Def Jam already by 91 was losing a little bit of its in the 80s. Russell's credo was like, we're not gonna bring the music to the masses will come to the music. It was a very uncompromising ideology at Def Jam, where it was like, we're just gonna put out LL and Public Enemy and Beastie Boys and Slick Rick is shit that's like not out there at all. I don't give a fuck if black radio or pop radio plays it. And it just sold records, because that's what hip hop was back then, like the best shit sold the most. It just was. It was a great time in the music. But by the 90s, Russell was trying to get radio songs. So, certain event, I was so disappointed that he didn't want to sell Organized Confusion. And the next two demos that came down the pipeline were Akineli and Nas. But I had gotten their demos, I think, from Large Professor. I don't even remember. Listen to them, you know, the original Halftime was on it. The original 88, It Ain't Hard to Tell was on it. That the original version with a different verse. And again, I was just blown away and I was like, fuck, you know, so. I knew after Organized Confusion that Nas was too technical for Russell. I knew that Russell would pass on this. I didn't want to waste Nas's time, Russell's time, my time. But I gave Russell Akineli's demo, which had a lot of punchlines and a lot of character to it. And Russell passed on it. Akineli wound up getting signed to Interscope. His album didn't sell that much, so maybe Russell made the right decision in that. But it made, and he never was given the decision to make with Nas, because I never passed him the demo. I just, like I said, I didn't want to just waste anybody's time. I think Russell would have passed on it as well, though.